What's going on, mi gente? I am Barbie305 and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So on today's video, we're gonna be running an errand trying to create an oxygen tank for my little baby, who, as I've mentioned to you guys before, has been sick. Oh, mommies, it's okay. It's okay, mommies. It's okay. Oh, it's okay. We're gonna go get you a tank. So, as most of you know already, that's Coqueta, little Cokers. She has a heart murmur, and about 3-4 times it's happened where she's gotten really anxious to the point where she can barely breathe. So I've had to take her to the hospital, like through emergency every time. She's almost had to stay overnight, and it gets pretty damn expensive. It got to the point where I had to buy her an oxygen tank. But she's a pup. Well, not a pup, but you know, she's a dog. So I'm guessing, obviously, the oxygen mask gets annoying for her, or she's uncomfortable with it. So she always tries to take it off. So in today's video, we're gonna try to make her an oxygen tank where we can just put her in there and she could get oxygen all night without having to have the mask on. So if you're interested and seeing how we pull this off, then keep watching. Unless you're still thirsty. You thirsty, Kobe? Thirsty ass. You thirsty. Dale, mama. Oh, my baby. Pero toma agua, mira. No, amores. Oh, my little baby. Princess, we're gonna go fill you with sand cokers. We're gonna have, ooh, you're gonna have your own personal built oxygen tank, specifically made by mommy and daddy. We have arrived to our first destination. Ooh. Oh, you're okay, mommy's girl. Here they are, perfect. Ow! Come on. Follow mommy.
comfortable there.
Okay, I think this is it.
Okay.
Hey guys, so we're at the second location now. I had to go and drop off little Coke because she was a little bit agitated. So we dropped her off home and now we came here to try to get the rest of the piece together. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna get an adapter. And, mi amor, no, you got the keys. You got the. Oh no, bro. Are you for real? Wow.
¿Qué me dijiste?
Baby, te dije, there's the keys. No, you know I always give them to you. Ajá, y ahora. Hey guys, so we got back from Home Depot yesterday, and as you guys were able to tell, we left the keys inside the car, so I kind of just like stopped recording and forgot to record all the little pieces that we got to build Coker's little princess oxygen cage. So I'm gonna show you guys right now exactly what we got, and then we're gonna build it with you guys. So, as you guys already know, we got this big container from Walmart. It has to be clear because she's gonna go in there and she's gonna be able to see mommy's, because if not, she's gonna freak out. All right, we got this to make the little holes that we need to make. We got this little thing right here. And all this little connecting little thingy majingies that they're adapters, I guess, because I need to connect to this the oxygen hose that came with the tank that I bought. So yeah, it needs to go in there and it just adapts to everything. So that's what we've got for now. All right guys, so we're gonna start with the top. We don't have a ruler, so we're just gonna kind of eyeball it. And yeah, let's do it. We'll be right back.
got this. And let's see.
God, you guys, we freaking did it. We freaking did it, go girl! Hey guys, so Coqueta actually already passed away, but I wanted to come on here and add this little clip real quick because as I'm editing the video, I realized that I made some small changes that made such a big difference. As you guys can tell, I initially had bought this adapter, which worked out perfectly because it already comes with a secure band on the inside. I'm gonna show you guys. It's like a bolt that secures the holes from any air leaking out. So that worked out perfect. I had also bought these adapters as well, which I showed earlier in the video. And this is what I said earlier in the video, to make sure to take your hose in with you so you don't go through the same thing I went through, because my oxygen hose would only go into like here, which is not even halfway in, because when I went to Home Depot, they didn't have this one that I'm holding, which is actually a bit smaller. Okay, you guys. So it will go in like this, right? So when I would leave it on for a while, I guess with the oxygen, I always had to like make sure it was connected because it would just come out. I don't know why. Anyway, so I went back to Home Depot. I found this little piece and I had to add this little piece as well because this one wouldn't fit on this one. So now I have three pieces, which that's okay. There's nothing wrong with it. They're all adapters, so yeah. And the good part about it is that with this one, the hose would fit, so it would fit all the way in, so I didn't have to worry about the hose coming out or anything.
Put it down now.
Wow, that looks so good.
Right now, this is our tank, guys, and I'll check in with you guys later and let you know if it worked out.
Mommies! Hi. You guys, how amazing is this? It actually has wheels, so it's even better because I can just walk around with pokers and take her wherever I want. Little coat! Little coat! They see me rolling, they hating, patrolling, they trying to kiss me riding dirty, 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 trying to kiss me riding dirty. Hey guys, so it is officially the next day. I was so exhausted last night that I actually didn't record her inside and whatever, but the tank came out perfect. The cage, actually, my bad. As you guys can see, we made this little hole here. She just got up because I came,
but as you guys could tell, she was in there chilling. I'm guessing this is for the air to come out, whatever. Like I said, I'm not a professional oxygen maker, so you might want to consult your vet. You might want to consult your vet if this is good for your dog. My dog loves it. Actually kind of wish I would have made this a little higher, but whatever. That's how we made it. The last important thing is that you need to put ice packs in there because it could get too hot for the pet to be in there. So they need to be a little cool. So I got these that I got from the dollar store. I actually want to go and get some more because I only have three. So I put them in there, and as you guys can see, she's just chilling. She likes it in there. Yeah, it's perfect. I'm gonna show you guys what I went by. The one that I saw online, it was actually a cat's, and it's a lot smaller than what I got. Oh, hold on, let me show you guys. So yeah, so this is what I went by. As you guys can tell from this picture, the little oxygen thing for her, it's right there. So the little bed could be big enough. As you can tell, the bed for mine, it can't cover this little hole, so I leave it up to there. But yeah, so I do recommend you take your pet with you, so you know, you could kind of see what kind of size you need to get. Coqueta is like, she's like 12 pounds, I want to say. And yeah, like I said, it worked pretty well. I don't recommend you, I mean, it's not that I don't recommend you to do it, I do, but you might want to talk to your vet about it first if you'd like. I just decided to make it and then message my vet about it, and then this is exactly what he said. Yeah, he asked me about the holes, which are the ones on top. He said they don't have to be huge. A lot of people that saw my Instagram, they were like, oh my god, those holes are so small. Like my vet said, they don't have to be huge. Those are the holes that he's talking about. And he said that it looks great. Oh, there he go. That it looks great, and he told me about the ice. Okay, you guys, so this is the end of the video. I really hope you guys like it. And if I could help at least just one person through this video with a sick baby, whether it's a dog or a cat, oh my gosh, it would mean the world to me. I know how expensive vet visits and emergency visits can get. So if I can at least help one person, it would make me so, so happy. I know I took Coqueta to the vet, to the emergency room actually about 4 times, and this is exactly what they did to her, which was put her on oxygen and they gave her an injection of Lasix. And I actually had that same medication at home, but I had it in tablets. So if I would have had the tank from the beginning, I would have saved myself $600 already. The tank where I purchased it, they also rent it for a month. So you don't have to spend $600. The oxygen tank does not need any refills. As you guys saw, the box that I made was just $50. And by any means, please don't, I mean, this is just what worked for my dog. So please consult your doctor first about what you should do. Don't think that you should just make this and not take your pet to the emergency room or whatever it is. Please talk to your doctor first, okay? If you guys need any help and you guys want to make this little chamber for your pet and you have any questions, just leave them down below in the comments, or you can also send me a DM through my Instagram. My Instagram is IamBarbie305. I would also link it down below, and I will be more than happy to help you guys with whatever questions you have. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and yeah, that will be all, and I will see you guys next time. Bye! Words can't express what you mean to me. Even though you're gone, you're still a team.
your family, I'll fulfill your dreams. In the future, can't wait to see if you open up the gates for me. Reminisce some time, the night they took my friend. Try to black it out, but it plays again. When it's real, feeling's hard to conceal. Can't imagine all the pain I feel. Give anything to hit half a breath. I know you're still living your life.